Hi everyone, welcome to this video explanation for the image number 10, verse 11 from the famous book The Secret, A Treasure Hunt by Byron Preiss. Today I take you to the fantastic city of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And just before we begin with the verse, I want to show you this reference to the city of Philadelphia in the image. We have an eagle shape here in the cape of the lady. We can see his beak and head on one side, and his claws are in the cape here. And there is also, I think, another smaller eagle to be seen in the monument-like structure behind the lady. I tried to show you here the eyes and his beak and claw. It's harder to spot, but I really do think we have an eagle there too. And as you probably know, there is a famous football team in this city, the Philadelphia Eagles. And I also noticed when I was doing researches about everything we could find in the city, well, there are a lot of eagles statues all across the town. We can see on the Philadelphia City Hall, on the Washington Monument, in front of the Art Museum. There are two, four eagles on the Lincoln Monument in the Fairmont Park. So I think this is a reference to the city in general. And during the path that we take from the beginning until we get to the treasure ground, we see many eagles. So I think this is a good clue that we are at the right place with this image and text. And we will begin with the verse now. Now, if we think about the most iconic landmarks in the city of Philadelphia, most of you will think of the Independence Hall. And this is actually where we will begin our journey. And first of all, I want to show you the walking stick here on the image. The walking stick is interesting for us because we can find inside the Independence Hall Thomas Jefferson's walking stick that is exhibited on the desk where he used to sit at the time. And as you know, Thomas Jefferson was the third president of the United States and the principal author of the Declaration of Independence. And I think this is a good clue that we are at the right place. And also, I want to show you the monument-like figure behind the lady on the image. As you can see, we see the spires of buildings on the top. This could be a reference to Independence Hall or the Philadelphia's City Hall, and actually many other buildings in the city. And you will see at the end of the video, we have another good reference for this weird shape on the image. But now let's see the first line of the verse, pass two friends of Octave. So here, Octave, I think, refers to music. I will quickly read you this description I have here. Octave is the interval between one musical pitch and another with double its frequency. Now, I don't want to begin with very complicated explications about music, because I am no specialist, but octave can be used to describe the sound of bells, and I think here this is what it refers to. What is very interesting is that an iconic landmark in Philadelphia is the Liberty Bell that is right across the street from the Independence Hall, and this is a very important figure of the American history, an important monument. And the other interesting thing from here is that when we are in front of the Independence Hall, we are standing on Chestnut Street, downtown Philadelphia, and if we go west on the street, we go until the South Broad Street, and then we have the building, the PNB building, and on top of this building at 1 South Broad, we have the Founder's Bell, and that is one of the largest bell in the world. So I really do think we have the two friends of Octave here with those two bells, and that takes us right behind the Philadelphia's City Hall in the heart of Philadelphia, and from here we can go on with our quest and it will make sense. And I also want to show you this very interesting thing about the image. If you look In the end of the lady, we can see she is holding a bell. And now I show you here with the image, we can clearly see a bell in her hand, and I think this is a reference to Philadelphia and a very good clue that we are in the good direction here. I just quickly want to show you this here. When we get behind the city hall, right on our path from the bells, we have this Octavius Cato Memorial just south of the Philadelphia City Hall. And when I was searching about references to Octave, well, I found out about this man, Octavius Cato, who was an important figure in the city, a civil rights activist who was killed in Philadelphia and who lived there. So it's interesting because we have the name Octave. So this could be a reference, but the memorial is very new, so it was not there in 1982. Was there something else referencing Octavius Cato at the time, and could there be something there? I don't know. No, I don't know, but it was interesting enough to put in the video, and just wanted to quickly show you that. And now let's go on with the verse. Now the verse says in December, and as you can see further in the text, we have also another sentence in July and August, and here it looks like the others seems to be indicating us directions with months. And what we will do here is take the 12 months of the year and put them on the clock, like December would be 12 looking north, and like June would be 6 looking south. And that is very interesting here, because we can find in the city of Philadelphia in Fairmont Park a very cool sundial that indicates months, and this is very rare. I have seen many sundials in other cities in the United States, but never one like this with months. There are probably others somewhere, but really this is rare, and I think here the other references this monument, and you will see our quest will lead us to Fairmont Park, not close to the sundial, but still I really do think here this is a reference to this particular sundial. So now, after passing the two friends of Octave, the two bells, and going north in December, we get to the Philadelphia City Hall, and here in the image I think we have a reference to this place. If you look in the neck of the lady in the dress that she is wearing, we have this weird figure with a square in the middle and like a cross shape around. Well, if we look at the city of Philadelphia from the air, we can see that this is the exact same shape that we have around the Philadelphia City Hall. And I tried to show you here with a drawing. We can see that the City Hall really is at the heart of the city, and then it breaks the grid of the streets, and then around everywhere around in the city, well, the streets are like normal square shape. So we really see it here on an old map of the city. It is much more clearly seen. So I think this is a reference to the Philadelphia City Hall, and it's a good clue that we are on the right path. Now the next line of the verse is "Ride the Man of Oz." Here I think this is telling us that we have to go on the Benjamin Franklin Parkway to go on with our quest. As you might know, Benjamin Franklin lived in Philadelphia, and is probably the most well-known character to have lived in this city, except for Rocky, of course. And if you know a bit Philadelphia, you know the Benjamin Franklin Parkway is this majestic avenue that connects the museum and the Philadelphia City Hall. And there is also this famous scene that you have probably already seen, where Rocky is jumping on top of the stairs. Well, this is the avenue we see in front of him. This is the Benjamin Franklin Parkway. And how can the man of Oz be Benjamin Franklin? Well, there is a novel from 1901 by the author of the wonderful Wizard of Oz, and this novel is named The Master Key, an Electrical Fairy Tale. And this is the story of a boy who performs electrical experiments in his workshop, and suddenly a demon appears to him, and he tells the boy that he accidentally touched the master key of electricity. This is funny because this is a reference to the Benjamin Franklin famous experiment he made with a kite and a key with lightning. So I think here we have a good reference between us and Benjamin Franklin. And there is also a famous quote from Benjamin Franklin, where he says, "An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure." So could the word ounce here be the reference to Ozzy? And now, as I was really trying to find something between us and Benjamin Franklin, I was looking at the $100 bill from the United States, and now Ozzy is known to be Australia. Australia is the land down under. So could it be the man of the land down under the Independence Hall? Because, you know, on one side of the $100 bill is the Independence Hall, and we started our quest at this place. So I thought that there could be something there, but probably not. And now I want to show you those two things on the image. There is this key that we can see here. I think this is a reference to the famous experiment that Benjamin Franklin made. And also, if we look at the monument-like structure behind the lady, we can see on the spires of buildings there are lightning rods. And as you might know, Benjamin Franklin is known to be the inventor of the lightning rod. So I really do think here this is a clue and a reference to him, and a hint that we are on the right path. Now the verse continues with "to the land near the window." This was a hard one, but I finally came up with something. There is a famous modern art photography that was taken in Philadelphia in 1939, and that is now in a museum in San Francisco. And this photography is named "The Open Window," and it was taken from one of the highest floors of the PSFS building in Philadelphia. And this building is not very spectacular when you look at it, but it has a very interesting history. It is a national historic landmark, and it is called the United States' first modern skyscraper. It's the first international style modern skyscraper. So this is a landmark in the city of Philadelphia. And if we put ourselves in the shoes of someone who lived in 1982, we have to know to remember that there were not as many skyscrapers as there are today in the city. So this was one of the highest buildings in the city. So and now the land near the window, I think this is a reference to Love Park, that was formerly known as John F. Kennedy Plaza. And when we stand at the corner of this park, we see the top floors of the PSFS building. And the interesting thing also is that when we are right on the corner of this park, well, this is the exact point where the Benjamin Franklin Parkway begins. So this is interesting. And also, I think we have a clue in the book. At page 109, there is this image with people that are flying, and there is this smiley smiley character with a t-shirt with the Love logo. And the Love sculpture is in this park, actually, the Love Park. So I think here this is our land near the window being this famous photography from 1939. And also I put this image here because when we stand at this point, there is those four eagles. So again, another reference to the eagles. Now the next lines of the verse are, "There's a road that leads to dark forest where white is in color." And this here, I think, refers to a photography that is inside the Philadelphia Museum of Art. It is named the Dark Forest. It was made in 1928 by famous artist Paul Strand. And I think "where white is in color" is just a wink to the fact that the picture is in black and white. And now we also have a double meaning with this sentence, because, you know, the road that leads to Dark Forest is the Benjamin Franklin Parkway that leads to the museum. And also Fairmont Park begins where the museum is, and you will see our quests will lead us to Fairmont Park. So the road that leads to Dark Forest has a double meaning here between this photography and the park. So now the next lines of the verse are, "with two maps after circle and square. And this is getting interesting for us because, as you can see here, about halfway on Benjamin Franklin from the land near the window going to the museum, about in the middle of the parkway, we have this place named Logan Square. And if I look at the Wikipedia article here, it starts like this: Logan Square, also known as Logan Circle. So this is very good because it fits perfectly with what the verse says here. And if we look at this place from the sky, we immediately understand why it is called like this. This is a big circle inside a square, so very nice. And the other interesting thing about this place is that there is the Swan Memorial Fountain inside the Logan Circle, and this fountain was made in the honor of Wilson Carey Swan with two N's, and probably the people who made the fountain liked to play with words because they made a swan that spits water inside the fountain. And now we have in the image 10, I think, a clue that we are on the right path here, because there is a swan that we can see. If you have a good quality version of the image, you will be able to see it. I tried to show it to you here. It's hard to spot, but I really do think we have a swan here. So that's a very good clue. And now the two maps. Well, if we look at this image of a map of Fairmount Park, we see that Fairmount Park officially begins around the Logan Square Circle. So I think the reference to the two maps here is just telling us that before this point we were walking in the city, a map with the streets, and now we need the map of the park. And there's also another meaning, I think, because you will see in a few minutes, but there is a hidden map on the image number 10, and I will show it to you in a few moments. So all of this finally gets us to the Philadelphia Museum of Art, but don't be celebrating too fast, the quest is not over. Now the next lines of the verse are: in July and August a path beckons to mica and driftwood. If you remember earlier in the video, I spoke about the reference to the sundial with months and how we can use the 12 months of the year as hours on a clock and get our direction with that. So this year, July and August, refers to that once again. And if we do that, we find that there is a path on the side of the Schuylkill River that begins near the Museum of Art. And if you look up on the internet mica schist and the Schuylkill River, you will find many references, and also there is driftwood on this river. So the description we have here fits perfectly with the Schuylkill River. And now I will show you the hidden map that helps us to understand that this is really the way to go. So I quickly want to show you this before. There is a reference to the path we took in the city. As you remember, I told you that the pattern in her neck looks like the shape of the streets around the city hall, and we see this diagonal here in the V-neck is a reference to Benjamin Franklin Parkway. So this is interesting. And now the very interesting path is here, and this is how I discovered it. I was looking at this bend in the river, and I finally realized that this shape really looks like her V-neck. And from there I got that there was a path drawn in her hair. And if you look at the line of her hair and cape, well, you see that this fits with the Schuylkill Riverside. And at one point the line of her hair is splitting from the edge of the cape, and this also fits here where we will quit the riverside and continue our path in the Fairmount Park. And now we have other clues to help us understand that this is really the way to go to the treasure ground. Now I just wanted to show you this. When we walk on the path along the river, we pass this very cool rock tunnel, and I think the drawing refers to this place. As you can see here in the cape, I think this is the entrance of this tunnel here, so maybe a clue that we are on the right path. And what is very interesting also is that in the famous movie Rocky, well, we can see Rocky passing this tunnel here, running along the river. Now, remember earlier I showed you that the path was splitting from the riverside at one point? Well, this is where we say goodbye to the Schuylkill River and we continue on our way. And this happens here at the Grant Monument. And if you see here, we have two tunnels that go under the railway. And I think those tunnels are represented on the image. If you look here at the two sleeves of the lady, I think this is a reference to the two openings of the tunnels. And this is a good clue that we are on the good path. And now this is the place where this leads us to. The place is named Edgeley Field and it's in the Strawberry Mansion neighborhood of Philadelphia. So you see we have made a long way since the beginning of our quest, but we are still in Fairmont Park, and now I want you to look at the shape of this field here. You see how it looks like the shape of the cape on the image 10, the eagle shape in the cape of the lady. This really looks like the shape of the field, and now look also, there are 7 baseball diamonds here, and this is exactly the number of figures we have here on the image. And I will show you a few things on the image that tells us we are at the right place, and you will see that the 7 figures and the 7 baseball fields are more than a coincidence. Now let's go back to our image, and I want you here to look at the red ball that she is holding in her hand. And now here, right next to the baseball field, there is a famous house that sits there, and this place is named Laurel Hill Mansion. And if we look at the history of this place, we see that there is a famous person who lived there. This person was named Philip Singh Physick, and he performed the first human blood transfusion in Philadelphia in 1795. And now, look here, this is very interesting. This image is associated with human blood transfusion. Sometimes when people give blood, they are asked to squeeze a ball to put pressure on and to reduce the time of donation. And this is an image that is really associated with human blood transfusion. And I really do think here we have a major clue that we are at the right spot. This is very interesting, and now let's see the rest. Now another clue that we are at the right spot. There is this very nice statue of an American Indian right next to the baseball field. And if we look here, it is kind of northeast from the baseball field. And this statue was made in 1899 by Cyrus E. Dallin, and if we look here on the image, we have this monument-like figure behind the lady, and it's kind of in a haze, and with the horns on the statue, I think it really looks like this monument. It's kind of if we were seeing it from the baseball field in a foggy morning or something. So this is very similar to the statue. And now I also forgot to show you earlier, but there is the millstone here. I should have given you an explanation when we were at the museum, but there is inside the Philadelphia Museum of Art this famous painting from Paul Cézanne, Millstone in the Park of the Chateau Noir. So I think here we have a good explanation for this millstone. Now let's come back to our verse, and the next lines are: under that which may be last touched or first seen standing. This is a very hard one to figure out, but once you get to the baseball field, well, it gets easier, and there is a solid explanation for this. If you think about it, it fits perfectly with the home base. First seen standing, well, this is where you begin with the bat, and you are there standing. And now if you make your way around the bases, and this is where you end up, and you last touched the base. So I think here we have a pretty good explanation for those lines, and this is also very good for us because we actually have 7 home bases that we can choose from. So now the next line of the verse is look north at the wing, and this here I think refers to the The Dell Music Center, if you look on this map here, it is right north from the baseball field, and this place in the 1980s was named Robin Hood Dell Theater. And if you look at the shape of the theater, well, it really looks like a wing. So I really do think here we have our wing. And now we have a clue, I think, in the text at the page 148. There is this text about the spirit of 76, and as you might know, 76 is a reference to Philadelphia. There are the 76ers, the famous basketball team, and this reference is because of the Declaration of Independence that was signed in this city in 1776. So here the spirit of 76 seems to refer to the city of Philadelphia, and the clues in the text, there is this weird sentence here, it reads like this: the spirit of 76 is a hybrid, of course, descended from the English Robin of the Woods, enemy of oppression, and from blah 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 blah. So here, Robin of the Woods. And this is a weird sentence, so I don't see another reason to put this sentence here than to give us the reference to the Robin Hood Dell Theater that we have here. So this is a good clue that this theater really is the wing that we have in the text. And now there is another clue in this text. At the end it says, spotters tips: the spirit of 76 is usually found at a maximum distance from monuments erected to her fame. And as you could see here, we are a long way from the Independence Hall where we started our quest. So this matches with the spotter's tips here, because the treasure here with the Philadelphia quest is very far away from the Independence Hall. So those were interesting clues, I think, in the text, and I wanted to show you that. There is a kind of ghostly figure near the end of the lady, and if you have a good quality version of the image, you can see it, but it's hard to spot. But I definitely see something here, and it really looks like the William Penn statue that we can find on the Philadelphia City Hall. And if this is really William Penn, well, there is no doubt that we are at the right place in Philadelphia with this image. And now, you remember I told you that there was a reference to human blood transfusion with the red ball that the lady is holding in her hand. But there is another red ball here that has no explanation, the red ball that is in the air. Well, I have an explanation for this ball. I think it is a reference to the Rocky movie. If you have ever watched this movie, you know that Rocky always plays with a ball, and he throws it in the air, and it keeps his mind buzzy and away from his troubles. So I think here it is a reference to the Rocky movie, and this is very interesting. And also, if we finish the verse together now, it says, and dig to achieve by dauntless and unconquerable determination your goal. Well, dauntless, unconquerable, and determination are three synonyms. And why would the other use three synonyms like this? Well, I think this is another reference to the Rocky movies. In 1982, when the book was released, there were only three movies, Rocky, that had been done at this time. So the third one actually was released in 1982, the same year the book was released. So I think here this is a reference to the Rocky movies, because if you know Rocky, you know that there is one word to describe him, and this word is determination. And now also, if you look at the shadow behind the face of the lady of the image number 10, well, it does not really fit. And well, could this be a tiger, like the eye of the tiger? This pretty much sums it up. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I hope I convinced you with my solution. So I really do think here the cask is buried under the home base of one of those baseball diamonds here in the field. I think it's the one with the key, but my girlfriend thinks it's the one with the jewel. So We are looking for a key in the cask, so this is why I thought it was the key. It could be the jewel also, it would be logical, so one of the two anyways. And now one very last thing about the image. Who is this lady on the image? Could it be? Well, I don't know. I see some similarities here, but you'll be the judge. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.